Hi everyone, I'm Ben from Freemius. If you have ever been a child, you've probably played with or at least heard of this. Lego blocks might be one of the world's most successful toys ever created. The great thing about Lego is that it's so simple to play with and there is no limit to what people can do with it. How does all of that relate to your WordPress plugin or theme? Think of it this way. The core features of your plugin or theme are like a basic Lego board, and add-ons are features that extend the capabilities of your plugin. Each of the add-ons can be bought separately, but none of them can work without the basic core features. In this video, I'm going to explore what the add-on model means for the pricing and development of your product, and ultimately how this can affect the sustainability of your business. Let's plug in! Many big players in the world of WordPress, like OceanWP with themes or NinjaForms with plugins, have managed to build their businesses using the add-on monetization model. But before you consider this model for your plugin or theme, we need to dive deeper and explain some of the pros and cons of using the add-on model from both the business and technical perspectives, so you will be able to decide for yourself whether it suits your product or not. We'll start with the bad news. First of all, from a technical standpoint, making a small change in the code of your core product may cause compatibility issues with some or all of your add-ons. Also, when developing a product with many add-ons, you are forced to make it very flexible by using a lot of actions and filters, aka WordPress hooks. This can cause meaningful increase in system resource consumption, since every hook triggers the do action logic. Basically, you'll have to maintain and update all your add-ons individually and make sure that they remain lightweight and flexible for your users. Let's move on to the business downsides. First and foremost, you can't charge for an add-on like you would on a full-on premium product. When selling a set of premium features, you can charge for all of them in one plan or tiered premium plans, but no matter the plan, you most likely won't make more than $150 per customer per year. That isn't the case with add-ons. If all of your features are sold separately as extensions, it would be very hard to sell any of them for $150 alone. Based on the market benchmarks, the most you'll be able to charge for a single add-on is $70 for a single site license. Another downside is the fact that according to many long-term plugins and theme veterans that have been selling add-ons for years, around 80% of your revenue will be generated from 20% of your add-ons. But regardless of that, you'll still have to maintain the not-so-profitable 80% of your add-ons, sometimes with very few customers using them at all. Going with the add-ons model can also create marketing issues. When using the freemium model, you can focus on marketing only the best features of your product. With the add-ons model, you may have to market each and every product individually, no matter how small its functionality may be. Otherwise, no one will buy those unmarketed add-ons. That means a lot more time is consumed on marketing. It's like having many small products instead of one. Finally, having many separated features for your product can sometimes be confusing for potential customers. Many users do not know what they really need or what is the best starting point for them. Paid plans called Starter or Personal can help guide users to the right place instead of offering too many choices, which can be distracting and frustrating, leading to lower conversion rates. Now, after discussing the downsides of the add-on model, let's start talking about all the bells and whistles of selling your plugins or themes with add-ons. One of the best things about add-ons is that only the essential features of a product are necessary to run the basic version of your product, exactly like the simple plastic square with round bumps on top of it. Using the add-on approach, plugins and themes become much more modular, which makes each one easier to test and debug. when you need to make changes to specific add-ons, you don't have to release a new version of the core plugin or theme. You just push an update for the required add-on. This modularity compels you to code a lightweight core product, which can be very beneficial later on when your product grows and becomes more complex. On the business side of things, there are also some great advantages to the add-on model. Instead of buying an expensive premium plan with a lot of unwanted features, your users can choose their preferred features a la carte and pay by the add-on. This makes it easier for you to sell your products because your user can customize the solution they need without paying for extra features. To help illustrate this, when selling premium-only products, it's very difficult to display more than 5 plans side by side on a screen. Unless your plugin or theme features exceptional functionality that no one else has, the price you can ask for a premium plan is generally limited to the established market range, which is typically no more than $200 per year. With the add-on model, you have much more flexibility in your pricing and in theory can make more money. If you have 100 add-ons, for example, that you sell for $10 each, one user can potentially buy all of them for $1,000 a year. But you'll probably want to give a friendly package discount in these situations. Now, let's go back to marketing. I know I said before that marketing add-ons individually can be more time-consuming than marketing them as freemium, but it also has the potential to be more effective. Promoting each add-on individually can increase traffic to your website and let you focus on the advantages of each add-on in your marketing strategy. Additionally, if one of your add-ons provides an integration for a third-party solution, it's usually a good idea to partner with that third party so they can list your product on their platform. This shows their customers that they are covered when they use your product in combination with theirs, and it's a great marketing collaboration opportunity for you. Finally, assuming your core product's code is well documented and was developed with extensibility in mind, other developers will be able to extend your product beyond what you can even imagine by creating their own add-ons for your products. The next step would be to offer them to market their extension on your site and charge them an affiliate commission, which is usually between 15 to 30%. Now that you've heard all the pros and cons, the decision is up to you. Just keep in mind that the vast majority of WordPress products are niche solutions with limited functionality. Therefore, in most cases, structuring your WordPress product as a core product with add-ons is probably the wrong way to go. Still confused or not sure? You can use this rule of thumb. If you see your plugin or theme as a platform that can facilitate many use cases and integrations, and you can imagine tons of different features and extensions to it, then I would definitely suggest going with the add-ons model. And don't forget to make it shine like a Lego brick. No matter which monetization model you choose, the worst thing to do is over-optimize it. We suggest following the data and by A/B testing your preferred model on potential customers. If you sell with Freemius, you can easily adjust your pricing in the developer dashboard to allow you to test what pricing levels work best for you and your customers. You can even work with your development team to separate some of your premium features and put them into their own add-on, so you can test this model. If you like this video and want to get more advice and best practices from the experts here at Freemius, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and blog. Feel free to ask us any questions in the comments below, and if it will be a really good one, we might turn your question and our answer into a video. Thanks for being a part of our community, and see you next time.